Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. And as an engineer for CSX for the past 25 years, I've pretty much been on every engine imaginable. In this video, I'm going to talk about different types of engines, maybe help you with your modeling, give them some ideas, and just give you an idea of why they use the power that they use. So we'll break it down into three types of engines. We'll talk about the big ones that are used for the big freight trains. We'll talk about the locals and then the yard jobs. So first, let's just talk about what's on the main line. If you're just watching the big trains come by, most likely today you're going to see what we call GEVOs. GEVOs, G-E-V-O, General Electric Evolution Series. I don't know. First thing I'll tell you is, as engineers, we have no control over what engines we get. When we show up, that train may be coming in from another terminal, or if we build the train ourselves, we don't get to pick what engines we have, because we pick a lot better than some of the stuff we use. So the Power Bureau is located, at least for us, down in Jacksonville, Florida. I'm working in Western Pennsylvania. Now, when I'm working out of Knoll, the coal trains, you're going to want to have the biggest, strongest power, because an average coal train is about 18,000 tons. These GEVOs, they're going to be listed as like AH, ET, AS, those type of engines. They're beasts. They are currently my favorite engines to run, at least on the big trains, especially anything I just referred to it as the 3000 series. So you might be asking, hey, do I have any footage from inside the cab? None personally, because we're not allowed to film while on duty. Also, there are cell phone detectors that are inside the cab, and there's also cameras, and they face me, the engineer, on the right-hand side and the conductor on the left-hand side. So yes, we are being monitored inside the cab. There's also a camera that's facing outside, that in case there's a train car collision or something, just to prove that the gates were down, the person ran around the gates. So there are cameras everywhere. If there is footage that I find later, it's gonna be taken off the internet and not my personal footage. So disclaimer. They're comfortable. They are definitely more comfortable. They are quieter. Now, if you've been watching me for the past 12 years on YouTube, I used to always complain about the Dash 8s. And those were like the CW40-8s, I believe. Anything that was former Conrail usually took a beating by the time we came to CSX in 1999. And so they were always, people were like, well, what did you hate about the Dash 8s? I hated them because the desk would rattle so much. We used to take spikes and wedge it in between the console and the side, just to try to eliminate that vibration. I mean, if you had a coffee, it was going to vibrate right off the console. So that was one thing I didn't like about the Dash 8s. Also, when the sun would come in during a bright day, it would hit your screens, and you literally couldn't see what was on your computer screens. They have started refurbishing a lot of those, putting them back in service, and they fixed those two issues, so I'm not complaining as much.
Hey, don't let this guy fool you. He still complains. But one thing he's not going to complain about is this.
You hear this? This is what I sounded like whenever I used to walk around with my old keychain. I had like six keys on here just making all this noise. It just wasn't convenient. And so I switched over to the Ridge key case instead. Do you hear this? You don't hear it. Look, simply pick the key that you want. There's a clip on the back. I'm holding up to six keys, and look at this. It matches my Ridge wallet. What a combo. So the combo, if you go on ridge.com/DJSTRAINS, you can save up to 30% on the combo. This holds up to six keys. This is probably the best wallet I've ever owned. The Ridge is sponsoring this video. TheRidge.com/DJSTRAINS. Get the link. Get some cool stuff.
Use the link ridge.com/DJSTRAINS and save 10% off your order.
So GE, General Electric, they are the ones that are making our DPU, our distributed power units. And that's why you're going to see similar units in the front and at the middle or even the rear of the train. They communicate. We don't just simply take, hey, you know, let's put a SD40 up front and a GP, you know, 30 in the back and have them DPU. No, it doesn't work that way. It's going to be these big GEVOs. That way there's good communication. It's all in the same computer software. It does take, you know, a handful of minutes to set up, and it's got to run through all the diagnostic tests. And that is DPU, and I've covered that in previous videos. So these engines are just powerful, but whenever I go to the first notch of throttle, it's not going to just take off like a smaller engine would, because if these things are massive horsepower, if you start pulling too quick, you're going to rip your train in half. So these start off very slow, but the thing is, it doesn't matter if you're down to like 1 mile an hour. These babies are just going to keep grinding until they get that train moving. Haven't seen anything this powerful before. So they also have what's known as dynamic braking. And dynamic braking is, it's electrical, we'll just call it that. The best way for me to describe it, I'm trying to make this more in just practical, like layman's terms, is imagine if you're on a bicycle and you're trying to pedal, and someone's like stepping on that tire and it's hard for you to pedal. It's pretty much like that. It's electrical, and it's kind of slowing the ability for our wheels on the engines to turn, and it's creating that resistance that slows the engine down. Does not control the air. Does not control the air brakes in the cars. It's just to slow the engine down. The dynamic brakes on these GEVOs, just a little bit, and you're looking at a windshield. It is amazing for being able to control your train. Another thing that we have that I don't think people talk about that often is we have what's known as Trip Optimizer. And for CSX, Trip Optimizer is cruise control. Yeah. See, TO, as we call it, knows our route. And even if it's like a 100-mile route, it knows where every single slow order is, every, you know, speed restriction. It knows how fast each segment of track is, because it's not like we just get the open road and just take off. No, it's like driving on your highway. Some areas are going to be 55, some areas are going to be 30, some 25. It's the same thing with the railroad. And so this knows how long your train is, when your last car goes through that speed restriction. It has the ability to speed up and slow down to match, to try to keep your train running the whole route, terrain and all, at a consistent speed for basically the track speed. So that's all the advantages of these big engines. It's pretty wild. Let's go down. Let's go down. I'm getting called to work. So now you get to see what life on the railroad really is like. You get called whenever you least expect it, all hours of the day, up to 7 days a week. I am working on part two, where I will cover the SD40s and some of the GP engines that are used on locals and on yard jobs. So please subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains, and I'm going to start filming the next part right now.